Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Let's Play Unreal. We're picking up at the beginning of the Sunspire, which is up in that direction. The last level was a lot shorter. It's only about 6-7 minutes long, which is kind of quite nice. As I said, I was saying in the last episode about pacing. It adds to it when you've got a sort of 25 minute episode or 25 minute level followed by 6 or 7 minutes. It makes a massive difference just to balance things out and give you a bit of a breather. I will not return to the Sunspire today. I was almost slain by the Sky Demon this morning, and I fear for our brothers who have not yet escaped. I feel that we will not see them again in this life. We're gonna go and see what we can do about that. Looks like there is something down there. And he's dead. Judging from the fact he was running towards me, I'm going to guess that it's either the Skaarj or Skaarj Trooper, and it's quite nice to still be able to take those out from a distance, even without something sniper rifle-like. And yep, it was a Trooper, which means he's probably dropped whatever weapon he was carrying down in the lava below us, which is a shame. Would have been quite useful, but hey, never mind. And I need to cough, give me a second. There we go. So, I'm not seeing anything else along here. Maybe something right there. Took a few bullets, but worth it. Anything you engage from distance makes things a little bit easier, and from the looks of things, he had an 8-ball gun, so even better reason to engage him as far away as possible. The last thing I want to do is be on the receiving end of one of those rockets. Got a Nali kicking around some. Nali just fell off. Nali just fell off the top of the level. Not good. Some shit's happening up there. I'm going to have to go and sort it out, clearly. Okay. Main door. Very ornate. Sunspire. Well, surprise, surprise. Hello. I'm here to deal with your Skaarj problem. Oh, wait. You are the Skaarj problem. Primary ascension. We'll go up there in a minute. Oh, hello. Dead? Didn't I kill you? Stay down. Ah. Oh. Another nice bit of music there in the background. The old Sunspire music. I'm just going to have a complete failure to take out a tentacle at close range. Showing off my prowess with the auto mag earlier. Chambers of Honor. Yeah, let's go see what's up this way. Somehow there is a Nali alive in the middle of all this place. Just meditating, just chilling out. Apparently none of these books are accessible. Ah, rifle round. Excellent. That means our hunting rifle will probably be turning up soon. We've got a bit more of a longer distance weapon. That's going to be worth a look. Especially in somewhere like the Sunspire, where we might be fighting a distance a bit more often. Yeah. Did not like the sound of that at all. Chambers of Honor. Second chamber. No, don't shoot the Nali. Leave the Nali alone, bitch. This one wasn't actually worth coming over for. start looking around upstairs next. Bit of an overkill just to deal with a tentacle, but never mind. More rifle rounds, some more ceridium rounds, some eight balls, much needed after our previous encounter with the triple titan. What? Oh, it's a gas bag. Probably close enough range that we can get away with using something that's not hit scan, but these guys do have a habit of dodging quite nicely. See? Nice, we can now finally take out those tentacles with one shot from the dispersion pistol, thanks to the upgrades we've been finding for it. Just some health and stuff down there, nothing really that useful. Do those tentacles get planted there, or... I don't know, do they grow there naturally, or do they just get planted there? It's weird. Just in really random places. I can kind of understand in some, say, the Teridium caves and stuff like that, the mines we saw them in. But in somewhere like the Sunspire, I can't really see the Skaarj going around, like, planting them and then feeding them every now and again. It just seems weird. Need to turn our flashlight off. Primary ascension. Somebody made it this far. Ow, ow. Should have changed my dispersion pistol. There we go, nice replacement flashlight. Guessing that's going to take us back upstairs. Yeah, let's head towards the primary ascension then. We've explored both sides. About those guys dodging. Come on then. And I'm out of ASMD rounds, that's a shame. That bitch. I think we gifted him on the way down. Oh yeah. Toast. Totally wiped out. Ascension. Another flashlight. We're not really using them much at the moment. Is that going to take us downstairs or is that going to take us upstairs? I think, yeah, downstairs. And we've already been that way, so let's go this way. Skaarj, nice. More Nali. Nice. Kill these bastards. Go up further. Let's go and have a look, see what's up there. So these guys, these spider type things, are Skaarj, basically Skaarj babies. Skaarj pupae. Okay, I don't know. Young Skaarj. They're probably the thing we could hear hissing on deck 4 of the Bran. Even though they oddly didn't turn up. The nasty buggers. They do a massive amount of damage, but they're just a pain in the ass. Relatively small amount of health, a bit more than the tentacles. It's a Skaarj baby in a barrel. I like that the... Oh, hell. I like that the, rather than the flashlight just suddenly dying, it kind of dims a little bit and then dies. Nice effect. Great. Another flashlight, always good. Hey Skaarj, murdering your babies. Where are you? Something there. What we got? What we got? Ooh! Minigun! Like the auto mag, but much more powerful. Primary fire is hit scan, which is always good, obviously, especially when we're getting to the point where we're fighting more and more enemies that can dodge our projectiles. About 8 to 14 damage a shot, and about 7 or 8 shots a second. Secondary is the same amount of damage, it's less accurate, but it's much faster firing, so good against larger targets like the Titans. Back through the kitchens. Go downstairs, find our way back to the primary ascension, see if we need to go up that way. Down there already. Another pupae over there. I swear I got at least 2 shots on that that should have connected. Kind of annoying that it didn't. There we go. Happened the second time as well, which is never good. So we're going to be going up this way, I'm guessing, because that's where... Ow. That's where those Skaarj pupae came from. I'm going to call them the Skaarj Young. Baby Skaarj. The only problem with the minigun is it shares the same ammo as the auto mag, so, you know, you want to use the one or the other sparingly. Ow, ow, ow. Bit of a failure button here. I can hear loads of Skaarj babies around, but I can't see them. Let's take out the immediate damage dealers, keep moving, and we'll take care of all of the gas bags. Be quiet. Unlike your grown version, you guys can't swim. That's interesting. Unfortunately, these are the kind of fish to bite, so we're going to be making a quick exit. Have some much needed ASMD ammo. Ah, this is going to take us back down where we were earlier, the kitchens. Grab some health, could do with some more armor. Burned through that stuff already, which is not nice.
Hello.
got 5 shots. It's not too bad, I can deal with 5 shots. Bit like the head crabs, only more annoying. Head crabs from Half-Life, you might remember them. Plan to do a Let's Play of Half-Life at some point in the future, probably Black Mesa. Now that they've announced Zen's coming out sort of summer 2017, I'm planning to do a complete run of Black Mesa when it comes out, which I'm really looking forward to. I played the first half of the game and just loved it. As a remake, it worked really well. Left me really wanting to see how they rework Zen, which, let's be honest, is the weakest part of the game. I'm just gonna whip out, get this black shell. More. Something else. My flashlight is gonna be dead in a second, so I'm gonna switch to flares instead. It has a book in it, but the book doesn't have a transaction. That's nice. Why am I wasting my bullets to open these boxes that have books in? Ow! Ow! Oh, you should be dead. A couple of direct hits from the Razor Jack, then I'm lucky to even survive. Sleeping chambers. Okay. We've got a new flashlight as well, so we're going to be using that. Probably stick with the shock rifle for now. Maybe some flat cannon. We have quite a few flat cannon. Quite a lot of flat cannon ammo, so we may as well be using it. New translator message. Feast Hall. Which is... Which way do we go? Bathing chambers, maybe up that way. Or is this the... Yeah, this is the bit we came to earlier on. I think we're going to be in one of those where do we go, what do we do kind of things. And if that ends up happening, I'll pause the video until I figure out where I'm going. So, I've kind of figured out where I'm going. Hopefully with the Sunspire now, I've at least found somewhere I haven't explored yet. Which is just off the Great Hall where we got the minigun. Apparently I completely missed a route through. Yep. Normally I'd say it's good that we're getting to the point of finding more enemies that we haven't killed yet, but there are a few levels in this game, and this is unfortunately one of them, where you seem to have infinite spawns of particular enemies. Like the Cran deck one, we had infinite spawns of Skaarj. This one is infinite spawns of the Skaarj Young, the pupae, the spiders. Which is a little bit of the pain in the ass. A little bit of the pain in the ass, to be blunt. But we do seem to actually have some semblance of a new area now, so I'm hoping we're going the right way. Lots of boxes and stuff we haven't destroyed. Lots of ammo, lots of health, and an invisibility, which isn't especially useful in single player. Again, it's one of those things that is better suited to multiplayer. You can sneak up on people, though. Sometimes in single player, we've done it with a couple of the Skaarj. Snuck up behind them with a rocket or a flat cannon shot right in their back. It's usually an instant kill. It looks like we might actually have a way out there. Go back and grab a little bit of the health if there's some left. Because it heals 20 points and I'm almost down 20 points anyway. Gotta remember there's another 60 points of health in here that we need it. Gonna need some auto mag shots at some point. Some bullets if I'm gonna end up using the minigun. Now the question is, do I head up or do I go back and explore a little bit further? And I think I'm gonna head up for now. Problem because the guy has a minigun, rocket launcher, a cannon, which from this distance, not massive problem, but when he has the high ground, he could splash damage to me to death if the AI were that good. This little starfield, we finally fought into the night. I'm guessing up is where we want to be going, to be blunt. To be honest. Actually found the sludge rifle. Guess by a rifle seems to actually work pretty well against these guys. Not least because you can put a few shots on them from a distance. And they can splash damage themselves in. Stuck on the barrel there. That guy. Another one behind me. Can't dodge from that distance, which is always good. He's got the Razor Jack, which we don't really want to be fighting against too much. Don't think he's going to be a problem anymore somehow. So, go up, or we can go down. I'm guessing the down section is where we came from a minute ago, so we're just going to carry on going up. Wow, that is a long way. Just reinforces my, yeah, this is the right way to go. Belief. Change back to the flashlight a bit later on. And the flashlight good, we're almost out of our current one. Chamber of Crystals. Another Gib. Gotta love the flat cannon for that ability. Well, we've done something. Don't know if lighting up the crystals is a good thing or not, but if video games have taught me anything, it usually is. Took a little bit of damage there, not too bad. Something out there, is that a lamp? Does have a habit of backfiring on you at close range fire. It's a bit like the flat cannon in that regard. Lots of bullets, always nice. Gas bags, just cannot dodge them, makes it much easier. Oh, bugger off. Bye! Have a nice fall! Whoa, and he's still firing at me. Yeah, I think he's probably dead. Either he hit the lava or he landed on the bridge down there, and either way, he's not coming back from that. There ain't no coming back, y'all. There ain't no coming back. Much needed super health back. Keep us going for a little while longer. Do we go around here? probably isn't anything, fine. Handy thing about using crouch in Unreal is you will not fall off a ledge if you get too close to it. Which makes it a lot easier to navigate around tight areas like that. We've got another pupae carrying around, but we don't really need to worry about him. I think we're nearly at the end of the level. Prepare to embark. Yep, there we go. It is coming out of the sky. Some chariot of God. So I hope it's not going to stop there, because there's no way I can get into it. Don't like the fact that it's covered completely on the inside with blood. That just doesn't bode well for me. Gonna wait here for a few seconds. Finally starts rising on us. And that should be it. We should be heading into the next area. I don't know what it is. So, this is the gateway to Na Pali. We'll see you next time where we'll pick this up. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.